The control unit is basically fairly simple to operate. This is the power switch. This is the on-off switch, if you will, or the stop-start switch. This is a counter, and then this is the intensity controller. We always start a session with the controller as far towards the negative as possible. But there are three basic coils that we work with. Number one is what's called a butterfly coil. In this particular coil configuration, the maximum field is in the center of the coil, in the center of the butterfly, either on the inside or the outside. And what you typically do is to open the coil up. You can treat somebody with the coil closed by putting it over an arm or a shoulder, and it will still produce a very high field intensity. The other two coils are long, and there are additional coils that are available for veterinary settings where you have have to have a longer lead, like for example with horses. But this is what I would call the loop coil, and you can configure it by squeezing it together like this, or putting it together in this direction, or leaving it, you know, basically a big oval. And again, it's usually used over the back or over the abdomen. Sometimes you can put it over a shoulder as well. You can put it over a neck to get the shoulder area and it was, say, cervical arthritis of the spine. Okay, and they can be used interchangeably. You can change them out and use different coils at each setting. This one is what we call the rope. So it's an extended coil that allows you to wrap around an extremity. So you can actually take it and wrap it around a whole arm. By wrapping it that way, you actually get a much closer field intensity, much stronger right at the tissue itself. All right? And then, so again, that would be used primarily for the extremities. So it produces a nice high field very locally, and again, can wrap an entire extremity as opposed to the other coils, which don't really allow for that. But once we actually get this activated, you're going to hear a clicking sound, and you know that power is coming, and that's the wires themselves banging against each other because of the amount of charge that's running through them. So you can hear the clicking, and that's a pretty rapid frequency. So at this frequency, you're getting a field intensity probably peaking close to somewhere around 800, maybe 1,000 Gauss. At the highest intensity, it can get up to 2,000 Gauss. And that rarely happens because that would produce some very sustained and very powerful muscle contractions, which could be very, very uncomfortable. So as you increase the intensity, okay, you hear the snapping decreasing in frequency. So rarely do I get upwards about this high with intensity. That's already beginning to produce some significant muscle contractions. And you hear the same clicking sound with each of the coils because of the discharge inside the unit. That's that snap that you get with the charge being discharged in the flash camera, in a sense, right? And then the energy running through the coil itself.